An absolute legend, Joseph Staten from Bungie's Halo days is returning to work on Halo Infinite and why this is so freaking phenomenal. Plus, Halo Infinite, could it suffer a 2-year delay to 2022? And also, if it does release on time next year, I might know exactly when it's releasing. But 3 for 3 addresses the rumors, Halo 3 ODST flighting update, and lots more to unpack. But first, be sure guys to smash that like button blue, as every like helps boost my video up the search results and helps get this news out to more Halo fans. Thanks so much, let's jump into it. This video is supported by Audible. Snag yourself a free Halo audiobook right down in the description below. So on Halo Waypoint, the post kicks off with Halo Infinite news, and the first mention is about the 2021 delay or release. Now, if you haven't heard by now, Halo Infinite was delayed to next year. And although this seems to suck a lot on the surface, I'm right there with you. Honestly, I think this is a saving grace to making the game from an average game to a great game. And although we've never had a definitive release date exactly which day the game is going to release, we always heard the game was going to release in holiday. I think here, as most people are assuming, that the game is going to be delayed a full year up to 2021 holiday. But could it get worse, and when exactly made the game release? Well, there is a rumor pointing out that Halo Infinite might be delayed to 2022, or whenever 3 for 3 is able to work back in the office. There's even some rumors of 3 for 3 dropping Xbox One support and more. But these are just rumors, right? And you should take them with a grain of salt. In fact, 3 for 3 actually addressed these on Waypoint. They say, please only trust statements made by official Halo social media or channels, studio leadership, or team members. Unishek, a community manager at 3 for 3 Industries, in response to the 2022 delay, someone named Eric was a little bit worried. He said, hey Eric, we're seeing a lot of fake leaks out there, so please don't believe everything you read. There are no plans to change our 2021 release or the devices and platforms we'll be supporting. We're building Halo Infinite to be the best it can be on each device and platform. So that is pretty reassuring as far as the Xbox One not being dropped and the fact that it's still being kept in the loop. I think it's a big part of the Xbox marketing and their new strategy with Phil Spencer, but I don't think there is really anyone that can say for sure that the game isn't going to be delayed unless they're really close to finishing development. Obviously, just up until a few weeks ago, we all thought that the game was going to be finished and playable in just a couple months here, maybe in October, November, or December, but that's changed. And a part of their announcement, and here's the catch here, is that them working from home was mentioned in that statement, and that is part of the reason, or maybe a big part, as to why they justified this delay. And I'm glad they did it, but I wonder if things don't change in the world, this might mean that Halo Infinite is further delayed to 2022. Although, again, it's reassuring to know that 3 for 3 has no plans to do that. Although, who knows, maybe next year rolls around and they're still not ready. Here's a funny thing about the game being delayed 1 year, because it might actually line up perfectly with another game's release to make an epic 20-year anniversary. Halo 1 released on November 15th in 2001. That means if Halo Infinite releases next year on November 15th, that would be an epic 20-year anniversary release. I think that would be a huge opportunity missed if they don't do this, if the game is going to be delayed that long anyway. Moving on, Halo Infinite's multiplayer was recently confirmed free to play and will support up to 120 frames per second on the Xbox Series X. And just by the wording, it seems that they're also talking about the multiplayer supporting 120 frames. I honestly think this has a lot to do with the lighting and how it's going to look much better on multiplayer maps than it does in the campaign even already. But I'll go more in depth about this soon. They also discussed the 3 soundtracks they've released that are going to be in Halo Infinite, that being Set a Fire in Your Heart, Revere, and Through the Trees. And these just sound phenomenal and totally worth a listen. It makes me not so worried if Martin O'Donnell ever returns to Halo. Even though that was always unlikely, I think why his music was very impeccable and iconic, these composers have given me hope that Halo Infinite's soundtrack can sound very classic while being new and not being done by O'Donnell, which is just phenomenal. I think it's a crazy feat, and I'll leave a link to listen to these scores down in the description. They are really worth listening to. So now we get to the highlight of today's video, and honestly, I kind of can't believe that this is actually happening. Bungie and Halo X developer Joseph Staten will be returning to Halo, quote, for a bit. Now, this is shocking because of the intimate and very, very, very large role he played in the original Halo games. Joseph was the director of cinematics for Halo 1, 2, and 3, and also helped a lot with scripts and dialogue. He helped develop mission scripts and helped make the cutscenes be what they are today. today, iconic and amazing. He also wrote the fifth Halo book, Contact Harvest, and also Shadow of Intent, and also helped with Halo Wars 1 and Halo 3 ODST's story. He's really one of the grandfathers of Halo, and it's without needing to be said that Staten is a lore master, and since he has intimate knowledge of the story, him working on Halo Infinite, even for the rest of the development cycle, which probably is pretty small, is still shocking. On Waypoint, they explained that he's one of the people to thank for making Halo's fun storylines, characters, and universe. Amen. So what happened here is that Joseph ended up staying with Bungie working on Destiny up to 2013, where eventually, long story short, he got screwed over and he quit, and he went off to the indie route. But it's really cool to see that he's working on Halo Infinite. In fact, he'll be the project lead for the campaign. And although it's pretty late in development, having his help is so very welcomed by myself and the community and 343. Really, my only concern about him joining is wondering how much of an impact will he actually make on Halo Infinite, considering that the game was supposed to be done in just a few months here. But 343 does keep talking about how the game is supposed to be a platform for the next 10 years, and that maybe there might be DLC or additional stories to tell with this quote-unquote platform and the Slipspace engine. So maybe Joseph will help with that and help with like a Spartan Ops kind of continuous story after Halo Infinite. But as far as Infinite itself, I wonder if he'll come in and advise things to be cut or changed or even add new things that will end up being extremely iconic. After all, again, he is the project lead for the campaign, and that's a super, super important role. I guess the takeaway here is that Halo Infinite, by time we actually play the game, whether you like it or not, the fact will remain that Halo Infinite is being touched by the people that really worked on the originals. Although there's people like Frank O'Connor and other people that have been involved with the original Halo games that still worked on Halo 4 and 5, but to have someone like Joseph Staten is really reassuring, and him being a part of a lead role for the campaign is extremely, extraordinarily good news for us, the fans. At least if you liked the originals. But in other news, Halo 3 ODST flighting has begun, and as they promised in the trailer, the game is set to release later this summer, and summer ends around the end of September, September 22nd or so, for the US. So ODST should be releasing in the next 3 weeks, which seems quite soon considering we don't have a whole lot of news about it. But regardless, that is super exciting because there is other content coming with the Halo 3 ODST release that will be in all the other Halo games, big patches and big updates like ODST weapons being in Halo 3 multiplayer, things like that you should be very excited for. Guys, be sure to snag yourself that free Halo audiobook. It's a quick sign up link down in the description. Guys, do you think Halo Infinite could be delayed to 2022? I know 343 basically struck down that rumor, but do you think it's a possibility with all the things going on in the world? And plus, how do you feel about the game being free to play, and how do you feel about the soundtracks? And if you haven't heard them already, you should go do it right now. It is really, really fun stuff. Also, Joseph Staten is returning to Halo. How big of an impact could he make on the game? Let me know down in the comments your thoughts about everything we discussed here today. Guys, I'll catch you in the next one soon. All right, you take care. Peace.